So the next one is security misconfiguration. And so indeed, errors in configuration of our APIs, the service that are hosting those APIs, the code itself, or other surrounding infrastructure can cause vulnerabilities. So most, you know, coding frameworks that we work with allow us to specify a debug flag or debug mode. And that helps us, you know, solve problems, troubleshoot problems, and really understand how the API is functioning on a targeted environment. But it's often a very common mistake or error that that type of flag might find its way up the chain towards a production environment. And that would enable malicious actors to use that more verbose data to maybe coordinate and exploit some vulnerabilities. So José, what would be some good recommendations for this type of risk?
Right. From a design point of view, we want to make sure we are applying restrictive and secure configuration across the stack by default. So like you said, some frameworks or perhaps all frameworks allow us to run the web server in debug mode or production mode. Then let's make it by default production so that we don't run into these issues by accident. And then if we want to run in debug mode in certain environments, then we can switch on that flag actively. Sometimes we also have the ability to run our services with authorization on or off. So then by default, let's switch on those parameters so that the service is running securely by default. And then in targeted environments with very controlled conditions, we can then switch off some of these flags and be able to see what's going on behind the scenes. But by default, let's make all these configurations secure.
Yeah, and I think having kind of the concept of kind of well-known configurations for target environments and having those validated as part of CI/CD flows is good practice.
100%.